If you have a child that has a developmental disability, they get put, the default plan is they go into development, they go into these sheltered workshops, they make like, I don't know, $1 an hour or something. But some of these kids are very capable of going out and working at places like Lowe's, where they can earn, you know, $7, $8, $9. John Martin's not here, but a couple things happen. One is they earn a little bit more money, and secondly, we're now allowing them to use the skills they have instead of putting them into a place where the skills that they have cannot be developed appropriately or properly. And this is like a big deal. I mean, maybe it's not a big deal for people that drive, you know, 80 miles an hour, but for those that live in this world, this is a really important thing. And I tell you, John Martin has done a heck of a job in getting people to work together, to share support services, to have common superintendents in multiple counties. You see, these people always get run over. And this is an example of where we're saying we're not going to do that. If we can eliminate turf, if we can combine overhead, if we can share superintendents and staff, there's more dollars to support people who find themselves in these circumstances that, you know, at times are extremely difficult. And to allow a developmentally disabled person to be able to use their full range of skills is just a great thing to do. And I don't want to just breeze past that, because too often those with developmental disabilities or mental illness or whatever, cripe, we don't pay enough of attention, and we try to do that here in the administration. I don't think that makes us anything other than doing what we ought to do, and it's important to all of us.